Okay, guys, so basically today we are covering the word cloud. So the first step, I have installed this word cloud. At the second step, I have imported this library word cloud. I have taken a sample text from Wikipedia, say any text like from this site, that is India Wikipedia India page. I have just copied it and I pasted it here. So I'll make a word cloud out of it. So this is a text that is looking here. India, officially the Republic of India, is a country in South Asia. It is the second most populous country or whatever it is. So the text that has been written here. So what I've been doing, I've been importing NLTK from here. And I'll say from NLTK dot corpus import will be small, I guess. Top words. And I'll say print. Top words. Words. And I'll say in English. These are the words. Around 179 words are there. So first, what I'll do, I'll say def word cl. Example, let me make it. I'll say abc. I'll say, okay, I have not imported my code link. Just give me a second. I'll say import matplotlib dot iplot as plt word cl abc, and I'll say plt. Okay, before that, I'll say def word cl abc, and I'll say plt dot figure. Fig size. So hope you remember we have seen this. So we initially fix a figure size here, say 10 by 10, say 15 by 15 or whatever it is. I'll fix it so that this portion is being reserved. I'll say plt dot imshow. Imshow is basically a plot that basically used for plotting the word cloud. So I'll say abc. So whatever the input the user will give, this will be plotted. Initially a figure size of 10 by 10 is reserved, then image show of abc, like whatever the text the user passes, is being displayed over here. And I'll say plt dot axis. I don't want axis, x axis and y axis here. So I'll say axis is equal to off. I'll remove this. I'll say shift enter. So now I have this. So so what I've done is I have just made a function with the help of which the word cloud will be made. So what I'll do is I'll say word cloud is equal to Okay. Brew this from word cloud board. So it is another library. I'll say word cloud is equal to word cloud. Whatever the width and height we do, width is equal to say 300, height is equal to 300 dot generate, what is the name of the text to generate text. If I'll say WRD word CL, so now I'll show you WRD CLOUD. It's an object, word cloud object that has been made and saved at this location. So what I'll do, I'll plot this. I'll say word CL. Word cloud, sorry. So it is a word cloud. I'll say yes. Word CL, word cloud. So now this is the word cloud that has been made out of the text we have. So we haven't removed the stop words yet, but I'll show you how to remove the stop words from it as well. So I set x is equal to off, then also it is showing x is. I don't know why. Let me check again. PLT dot x is equal to off. I'll say on. Now what it will do? I don't know why it is showing x is. I have initially mentioned to remove the access, but I know. Okay, I'll see into that. So what is this? Is like the word that has been repeated the highest number of times is being displayed with high text caption. So this caption is INDIA. India is of the highest number of time that has been mentioned. And whatever the words that are surrounded to India are the words that are basically mentioned near to the word India and with that much of frequency. If I'll say, here's a word country. So whenever country is mentioned, language is also mentioned because it is of similar text size and country language. Whenever South is mentioned, emerge is also mentioned, and to a lower extent, China is also mentioned in the text that we have mentioned. So this is a simple example of word cloud. We can beautify the word cloud. There are many options. Let's say dot background color. I don't know the things, but I'll say background color is equal to say green. Let's say shift enter. So there are many things with the help of which we can beautify it. I'll say the background color has been green. If I say background color is equal to pink, it will be.
So that I am.
Come again. I didn't get you.
Sir, that I am PLT dot I am show ABC. I've written a sir.
Yeah,
so
this
is
one.
Is that for displaying the? Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Is that for displaying the graph?
So there are two things. One is I have been making. Yeah, this is for displaying the graph. This is for showing the graph. So whatever thing we have passed over here. So what is the thing we are passing here? Is word cloud. This word cloud. This word cloud is a. We have made it in an object kind of format. So I have already taken. So there are two things in it. If you remember it, okay, let me show you. If I'll say 1 by 1, if I'll say shift enter, 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 and if I'll say shift enter. So the entire plot size is 1 on 1. Okay, the region that has been plotted over the end is 1 on 1. If I'll make it 10 on 10, just be with me, I'll say 10 on 10. This is the figure size, the overall figure. And if I'll make it say 3 by 3, that example. Shift enter, I'll say shift enter, and I'll say shift enter. So it will be saying that it won't be possible with 3 by 3. When I have space to draw, okay, I'll increase it. I'll say 30 by 30. I'll say shift enter. I'll say shift enter. I'll say shift enter. You see, now the area is reserved 10 by 10. But the plot of the of like where the cloud has been pasted is very haphazard, because how it works is, let me show you. So this, when I say figure size, it will reserve this area for the figure. But when I'm saying word cloud that has been made, so this is the density. Like if I'll say now, you see it's better. So it's basically that, but as I go on increasing it, so this is the parameter of the word cloud that is being made on. The earlier that parameter is a figure size, and here the word cloud is being made over here, but it has been shown through here. I hope you're getting me.
Yes, sir. Got it, sir. So one more thing, sir, in the stop words English you have written. So English means you're specifying the which language, sir, here.
Yeah. So if I'll say Spanish, these are the words that have been defined in Spanish in Python as a stop words. So these will have the meanings similar to English only, but to their language. If I just, these are the German words. If I'll say here, say, so it is saying, because for Sanskrit we have a different kind of a library, or I don't know whether it has been formed or not. So this has been formed for some of the languages. I'll say Hindi. Hindi also it is not defined. I'll say French. It is defined for French. For some of the languages it has been defined, but for the Hindi kind of a language, I guess I have we have certain other libraries. So let me, yeah, it's a good thing that came out. Just give me a second. Even I haven't tried for Hindi.
Sir, I had a question.
Yeah.
What if the text is mixed in like language wise? If will it still be able to exclude the stop words in both languages?
So what you need to do, you need to bring the text into a single language through Google Translator API that we that I have used.
So it needs to be in the same language.
Yeah.
Achha, okay. And it will this excludes all the stop words, na?
Yeah.
Achha, okay.
Stop words. Just for my curiosity, I've been seeing it. Which library is there for? I don't think they have any library. Okay. it hasn't posed. I don't know whether it has been done or not. But for some of the basic of the languages, we have these keywords that have been defined. So for the other question, like if it's a mix of languages, so what I normally do is I translate it into a single language through Google Translator API. It will allow you to translate, say, first 1,000 words for free. Then it is basically chargeable kind of a thing. So we need to purchase it, but that is the thing. So Python also has some ways of translating, but on the back end, it uses the Google Translator API only. I have done it around two and a half years back. At the time, it was a scenario. Might be it has changed now, but like it uses the that only for the same. Any other question anybody has?
So using different languages like you did in Hindi, French, so somewhat, so we are translating into some different, bringing in the same platform only, na, sir?
Yeah, you're right. So basically for French, if let's example, you're working for a French text, you're working for a French text and you need to prepare a word cloud or do some pre-processing, then you need to deal with this French stop words and all the things needs to be done in French only. It's similar to English, like that thing that we have done. But the thing is, it will go in French or German or whatever language you're doing, working on.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can we fix the threshold value, like the frequency which is less than 10? I don't want to print it.
Yeah. That is also an option. So that has an option of minimum frequency. Let me check if it is there. I haven't tried here. Font size, minimum word length. Minimum font size. Okay, minimum font size is equal to say 10. So this will exclude the words which have less frequency, I guess. So let me see. Okay, first let me change the size as well. It is not visible. In R, I have tried it. That is an option, minimum frequency. But here, let me see. So here, let's simply, if I'll say minimum font size 10, you see some of the words that were there are not coming. Here, the option is minimum font size. If I'll say 5, some other words will start coming. So you see. You see some other words which are less frequency are still coming. So here the option is minimum font size, I guess, but I can search for it. So in case there is an option that will come, we can use minimum like width, height, max words, relative scaling, normalize, plurals, generate from frequencies, you know. It has been trying to make its own function, something like that. So we can simply use this, like the thing that we have seen. Minimum font size. It is like to a minimum frequency only. Anybody else? Any other question?
Yes, sir. Yeah. So in Word Cloud, you are not specifying a language. So Word Cloud will pick the most frequent used language and choose the words, na?
So the Word Cloud is being made from this text only. This text.
Correct.
So this is in English. So Word Cloud doesn't know whether it's English or not. It has a certain rules. The rule is, if any of the word is being repeated highest number of time, the font will increase. So in case it is India or any other language, any other word, it will come here.
So language is not a specification in Word Cloud.
Yeah, because Word Cloud. Yeah, frequency, how these words, two words are near or far from each other. And all these things the Word Cloud will consider, and it will do like this.
Correct. Achha, okay, got it. That's all.
So
what is the PLT axis of is
so yeah, I have tried it, but I know I okay, I'll say off. So what I've been trying to remove these axes 0, 50, 100, 150, but I don't know why they are not being removed. So let me try again. So it basically says PLT.x is equal to off, which means like I have been trying to switch it off. Let me see if it works or not. It will not work like this. It will throw an error. X is equal to off. Off is not defined. So I'll say false. Let's example, I'll say. So I will try. So there might be some parameter. Actually, I didn't want these X's to be displayed over there. Now also X's are coming. So there will be some parameter with which I can get rid of the axis. Let me think. So this is the parameter which I have mentioned for that only. I don't know why it is not working. It might be some other thing. Also, it's coming. So it is basically for removing the axis. So we can just simply check how to remove the axis from plot. So it will give you a parameter and we'll do that. So this is like, but that is the thing which I have been trying to do. PLT dot axis is equal to off. I can try this as well. Let's think PLT.x is going to off. It is working. It is not fig, it is fig only. So if I'll say
so in PLT dot axis remove equal to
PLT dot
Axis. Where it is off. You have written off.
Remove. I'll say remove.
No. Remove that equal to sign.
Okay. Let us try this. No, it is there only. It will be there only. So I've been trying another thing. I'll say shift enter. I'll say shift enter. Shift enter. No. Get x axis. So it will be something else. We can try it off. Was not working. So some of the times, like some of the things get changed and they won't work. They won't work. So it's not a problem. It's a very small thing, which you can explore or we can explore, and it can be done. It is not a problem. So it is just to remove the excess. In case the excess are not being removed, then color them in a white color. So that's a thing like which we normally do. In case though they are not being removed and you want the same to be removed, then you can change it to the white color. So, but there would be some parameters. The parameter keeps on changing all the time. So the thing that have been mentioned might be from the past, but there's no problem. That can be done anytime. Like only bit of exploration is required. Okay, guys. So now the other thing is, I'll say, stop words is equal to set. Stop words. Words. I'll say English. So what does set mean? That mean in case there are any duplicate words, that then those words will be removed. See. So this has converted. Just give me a second, guys. So this is set is just because in case set that we have discussed like initially, so this set is being used whenever we need to remove the duplicate words. But in case you don't want, then you can ignore it as well. I'll say filtered sentence is equal to say A for A in okay, before this I need to do the tokenization as well, so just give me a second. What was the text? I'll say from NLTK dot from NLTK dot tokenize. Yeah, it was tokenize import word tokenize. So let's in this scenario, and I'll say word tokens is equal to word tokenize text. So if I'll say word tokens, this has been created in the form of a list word tokenize. What I'll do is now say, I'll say filtered sentences A for A in word tokens if not A in stop words. This is just a loop. Which is, let's say, if I'll say for A in over tokens if A not in towards return A. So this is a simple for loop which I have written over here. So I'll say shift enter. So if I'll say filter sentences, I'll say shift enter. So whatever the store words were there, 179 store words that we have seen in English. Will be removed. So if I'll say filtered sentences. So now the thing is, these filtered sentences are in the list. If I'll say simply say shift enter, this will return error. Why? Because expected string or byte like object, but this filtered sentence is a list. So we how do we do that? I'll say def l2s. I'll say str1 is equal to blank. I've taken a blank string. So I'll say, so I've initialized a blank string. I'll say return str1 dot join. I'll say s. So I'll say shift enter. Now I'll say fs is equal to l2s list to string. I'll say filtered sentences. I'll say shift enter. Now if I'll say fs, this will be like the filtered sentence kind of a thing, fs. And now what I simply do is fs. I'll say sorry, I guess it has not been copied. This was a thing. Now you see it will be better kind of a thing. So now the another thing is what you guys can try. So there are many types of pre-processing that we can do here. We can remove punctuations, remove numbers and a number of things. So these are the things which you have to try, guys. You have to do all these pre, like the way I have shown stop words, a similar way you can remove the punctuations, you can remove the numbers in case you want to, because anyway this word cloud will not give you the punctuations because the length is very less, like the number of punctuations will be very less, or the numbers will be very less as compared to the words we have. So it will not give you the numbers, but in case you want, you can just do the pre-processing and make it more refined.
Hello, sir. Sir, there are other kind of stoppers. Like in this scenario, we have India, which is not useful actually. So those also comes under stop words, no, sir. So how can we remove such kind of stop words?
So
like
you can...
India, country. These are all about India only. We don't want that words to come in this.
So the list that has... Just give me a second, guys. Just give me a second.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, the question was how to remove the different stop words which we actually wanted to remove. So the answer is, so the list that we have made, this filtered sentence. So here, don't you think we can amend this stop words list? We can make another list of the customized list of the words that we actually want to be removed and append this list with the stop word list and follow the same function. So this will remove all other words which you actually wanted to remove. Are you guys with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I can try writing a custom function with the help of which anything can happen. Like we can remove any of the word, we can remove any of the particular word as well, any punctuation, and a number of things we can do. It's just a game, like how you better pre-process or explore the data. Anybody, any other question or any doubt till now?
So there's no need to do DTM matrix and find the value counts and then using that create a workload. Isn't that the processor? Like
we can go with that route as well, but that route is a lengthy route. So DTM, if you'll do, so here you will be. So when I've removed the stop words, say filtered sentences with the help of which we have removed the stop words. So there you have been supplying like the list of the words with their frequency as well, which is helping it to make a word cloud. Here it is calculating the frequency as well by its own. So that's the difference. But you can take any of the route in case you want to. Both will produce a similar kind of a word cloud.
Okay.
So I'll show you a very simple example of sentiment analysis, because so normally when I do the sentiment analysis, it's with the text blob library. So, but the thing is, it's not limited to text blob. It's a simple kind of a version of sentiment analysis, which I've been showing to you guys. But this can be extended to any of the version. This can be customized. So we can make it with the help of polarity scores, with the help of cosine similarity. We can embed certain our own rules as well. That will be the detailed version of it. But I have been telling you a simpler version so that it's very easy for everyone to understand. And you guys with time will be able to do it. So let me show you. I'll say. Okay. I'll say. So this is an inbuilt library in Python. How many of you have seen this library or use this library, text blob? Anybody who has used this library, text blob? So this library is an inbuilt library which helps in doing this basic kind of a sentiment analysis. I'll say from So let me tell you two things before we continue. So one score is known as polarity score. Second score is known as subjectivity score. So when I say polarity score, this ranges between -1 to +1. -1 means purely negative sentiment. +1 means purely positive sentiment. So it depends, like within, sorry, within which value the score is lying, and it will try to predict the score of that. So subjectivity score is, it basically tells whether the sentence, so it normally ranges between 0 to 1. So it is basically used to tell you, so whether the sentence is subjective or objective. So if it is 0, the past sentence is objective, else the sentence is subjective. So this library, TextBlob, is an inbuilt library for sentiment analysis only. Earlier we need to write a lot, we need to define our own rules and many more things for the sentiment analysis, but now the TextBlob kind of library has been introduced, which helps us to do all these things with much more simplicity and the higher accuracy. So I'll take any sentence, let's say example. Let's say outcome is equal to TextBlob sentence dot I'll say sentiment. I'll say print. It is saying a polarity score of 0.8. So the range is from 1 to +1. Here it is 0. So it is coming somewhat here, 0.8. So this is coming somewhat here. This is a positive sentiment kind of a sentence. And another thing is, subjectivity is 1. So this is purely subjective kind of a text, which means it is not objective. Objective is a one word, two word kind of sentence, or objective. Or I'll say it's very bad experience in learning. It is simple. says minus 0.90 as a polarity, which is somewhat here. Subjectivity is same because again I passed the entire word 0.86. So again it is same. This sentiment, earlier when we used to work on sentiment analysis, we need to calculate the things by our own and all the things, but now these libraries have been introduced, which will help you in predicting the outcome in a very high, with a very high accuracy. And so if you have to tell anyone whether this has a say outcome, this will be the sentiment score of the sentence that we pass on. So this is a simple example of sentiment analysis that we work on. Are you guys with me?
Yes, sir.
So this helps in identifying the sentiment of a sentence. You can pass a very big sentence as well, say. This is a positive sentence. So we'll see how positive it is. Point 0.8, so it is highly positive. So I'll say so there are no negative thoughts that are coming. So I'll say this only. I'll take till here. Say like this. The polarity went to minus 0.2, which means this is a negative thought, or a negative kind of a sentiment is coming out of it. It has a negative word in it. So if I remove this negative word as well, say, then I'll say polarity is minus 1. You see. So as I remove this, these negative words with the positive words, say braveness. Inability is a negative word. I'll say ability. Fear, I'll say brave. Very simple. It has gone to 0.35. You see how the polarity score is increasing? Because I have been putting some positive words in it. Apprehension is a negative word. This means reluctant. I'll say possible. Fear, I'll say See, the probability score has further gone to 0.23. So this is the this is a thing, like how the words are, how they have been used. What is, if I'll say the word, say, person is very bad. It is -0.9. I'll say not very bad. It has come to 0.269. So it is intelligent. Variable is used, but now it has been used with an interrogative or a negative or a note kind of a word. So it has changed the meaning of the entire line. You see how intelligent the text blob has made the sentiment analysis as. If any of the negative thought is being followed by a note, then this will make the entire sentence positive. I'll say not very good. See, -0.26. Are you guys with me?
Hello, sir. Sir, I have a doubt. Like in general, if I want to perform sentiment analysis, like for the reviews, taking a reviews of a product, mm-hmm. and I want to perform sentiment analysis, so there's no need that I should know predefined, like it is positive statement, negative statement, or neutral statement.
So, no, the thing is, like, you can go with that text classification kind of a thing that we have
done. So, that would be text classification, but
So this text blob library already has a lot of rules that are being defined, and the rules are very complex. The thing that we have seen, like the very good, not, and all these things are already being defined. How far the negative to the positive word is, and all these things are defined. If you do a custom coding of your own, you won't be able to reach this much of accuracy, which this inbuilt library, which Python has launched, is giving.
Okay. One more thing, sir, so sarcastic comments too. So will blob will read that also, or instead of we should do POS tagging?
So it's a two-way around. So it has the ability to understand the sarcastic comments as well to an extent. But you know, like whenever you will be doing your custom coding for the sarcastic comments, you won't be able to achieve a very good accuracy with your customized coding as well. So that's the thing which I can tell you at this point of time, because every sentence, because it's a natural language. So the way it has been spoken by you and the way it has been spoken by me will make a lot of difference. So you say, it's very good that you wore a dirty shirt today. So it's a sarcastic comment. You're saying it's very good. And on another line, you're saying you wore let's say, just give me a second, guys. You wore a dirty shirt or dirty pant. So now the thing is, so this is a very simple sarcastic comment, but the sarcasm can go to any extent. So a line that has been spoken has a sarcastic comment as well. So the line which I have just told you, like, it's very good, you wore a dirty shirt today. So it might be a sarcastic comment. But it might be a sarcastic comment if it has been spoken for a particular scenario. So, for example, the team is going for a play, and it has been advised to the people that they will be playing a role of a beggar. So it's very good that you wore a dirty shirt today. So it might be a sarcastic comment for us, but the context it has been spoken is, it's not a sarcastic comment. It's really a positive kind of a thing that is coming out of it. It's really very good that you have done this because you have been advised to do so. So this part is missing. So this was actually appreciation, but somebody can take it as a sarcasm as well. So the thing is, you won't be able to achieve, even if you do your custom coding, you won't be able to achieve a very good accuracy with sentiment analysis in a sarcasm kind of a scenario. But it, to a higher extent, it will be able to do, provided whatever the sentence that has been provided to, like this text block that we are working right now.
So my doubt is actually, we shouldn't use POLTI.
Your voice is breaking.
My question is like, we shouldn't use POS tagging, sir, for this? No, or can we use POS tagging for this?
So in case you are doing your, in case you want to, say, let's example, this thing that we have been trying to solve now, in case you find any problem or you think that this is not working fine for some of the sentences and all the things, then you can go with the POS tagging and you can define the words as negative, positive, and all the things by your own, and you can go ahead with it. There's no problem. So but that will come under the custom coding kind of environment, which you actually want to do when this particular library is not meeting your requirement. So this does all this POS tagging and all the thing on the backend. This package that has been built on does all these things in the backend.
Okay, sir.
So with time, the NLP and everything has started emerging. So the time when we started, so like there were no tools like to perform statistical analysis. We have been doing statistical analysis on a pen and paper. We have been referring to like the Z table, the T table, and all these things to perform statistical analysis. But with time, I have seen like the things like SPSS and all the things came, Minitab, SPSS, and all the things emerged. And then like it has gone to open libraries like R, Python. Earlier when I started using R, R is missing with major of the functionalities. So whatever you are trying to solve, it says this is like a kind of a message comes, which means that this thing is not currently available in R or not possible in R. So with time, these communities have started emerging. So with time, you will see that some of the complex things that are being here are being solved through the inbuilt libraries. So the things that we know right now, with the things, the calculations that we do right now, will not be required in future, where all these things will be available in a package. Are you guys with me?
Yes.
So anybody, any question, not from this topic, but from any of the previous topic as well. So anybody, any question? So this, the agenda of this session is basically to cover, to take your doubts. Okay, one of the doubt, somebody sent me a screenshot of the probability. So it was like, it needs to be find like what is the probability of PE by D, conditional probability, and a chart has been provided. So the thing is, how we can solve it, we can go to the formula PE by D is PE intersection D divided by PD, and we will try to solve this problem if PE intersection D, which means PE and PD probability is given, we can calculate this and divide it by PD. So this is the formula that we can use in it, and we can try solving that. So it was for the last week, somebody sent me one of the question with a screenshot. So anybody, any doubts?
Sir, I have a doubt. Like, I just want to know what are the issues we face using this text NLPs. Like, we pass text and we get accuracy in text classification also. If the accuracy is not the good one, so what are the ways? What ways we can do?
Yeah,
like, we can reduce the text or?
No. We don't have to reduce the text. There are two things which we can work upon. One is how beautiful you process the text. One. And second is how interchangeably you use your models. So these are the two things in this text mining when you are basically working on improving the accuracy of the model. So how beautifully you process the text is one of the key. So you know, every time it comes to, so let's example, you are constructing a house or you're constructing a small room. So The thing is how we can make this room more attractive, more beautiful, more good looking. So the thing is how you make it and how you will decorate it are the two things. So here as well, how you process the text is the first thing. Process the text means when you are building the walls, how beautifully you will putting the base of the algorithm which you're trying to solve is removing stop words, removing punctuations, removing all this. So these are common, but after that, the final thing comes as how you go into a text manually and remove the things that are not making sense or you think the machine won't be able to understand is the thing where when you work on ground, then you will be able to achieve higher accuracy. Else, if you improve the, if you go on improving the accuracy by like the techniques like removing punctuation, removing number, removing stop words, removing rare words, improving spellings, the accuracy will improve by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7%. With the models, it will further improve to 2, 3, 4, 5, 7%. But the major of the improvement comes if you go to ground. And if you actually see the text, why it is happening that machine won't be able to understand it. The apprehensions that machine has, the things that are reluctant, which machine is facing, those are the things, those are the bottlenecks. If you remove from the ground, then machine will be able to give you the better accuracy in the future. So that is the key all the time.
Okay, so got it. Sir, and one more thing we are left is like you explained time series, you already explained ARIMA model also, but we didn't execute it.